Yo, Mr. iMob, my name is Rayo, and if you just recently started out streaming on Twitch, but your stream is looking a little bit boring and you want to make it look a little bit something like this, or even something like this, then I'm here to help you. When in my last video we did the bare minimum to just start streaming on Twitch, then in this video I'm gonna help you make your stream look a little bit more professional by adding overlays. There are two ways you can create overlays when you're using OBS Studio. One way is to create them directly in OBS Studio, but that's not really a preferred way because it's most likely going to clutter up your sources when you add a bunch of images and possibly videos in there. And secondly, when you add a bunch of images and videos, then it's gonna take up a lot of resources again. The second and the best option is to use Streamelements. Streamelements is basically a website and an OBS Studio plugin that you can use to easily manage your stream. This is the best choice because it's only gonna need one source and you can add all the images, videos and extra stuff you need on your streams. And if later on we want to add alerts to our streams, then we're gonna have to use Streamelements anyways. So that is definitely the best option. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go to Streamelements webpage and we're gonna download OBS Live Streamelements plugin. It's basically an extension for OBS Studio. It's wonderful. It's gonna help you do a lot of things much easier. So go ahead and download, install it, and then when you open your OBS Studio, you can see that you can now connect your OBS Live with Twitch. So make sure you do that. After you've logged in, then just leave it there right now. We're gonna come back to this later, but now let's go to Streamelements website again. Of course, link is down in the description. And on Streamelements homepage, we're gonna connect it with our Twitch channel. So now that we logged into Streamelements, we are on our dashboard, and this is where things might get a little bit overwhelming at first because there's a lot of things we can do here on Streamelements. We can change our tipping settings, we can see our revenue history, we can add merch to our streams, we can do a bunch of customization to our streams through loyalty settings, leaderboards, contests, giveaways. We can even use Streamelements' own chatbot that is extremely well designed. Anyways, today we're just going to focus on overlays, so let's head on to my overlays. So as you can see, here are a bunch of my overlays. It's looking a little bit messy right now, I gotta say. I should maybe clean this up, but there's two ways you can create new overlays. First, you can create a blank overlay, which will give you like 100% customization options, or you can download some pre-made overlays as well if you don't want to make your own. If you go to Teams gallery here, then you can see that all these overlays here are already pre-made and you can pretty much just copy paste them on your own streams. It's a really good option when you don't really care about making your own overlay at first, but eventually I believe that you would want to either create or have someone else create your own overlays. If you absolutely don't care about creating your own overlays, then you can just download any of these here and skip the whole section on this video where we talk about creating your own overlays. So since many of you will want to create your own, then we're gonna head down back to my overlays and we're gonna create a blank overlay. So here, first thing you can do is choose your overlay resolution. It doesn't really matter which resolution you choose, but it doesn't hurt to choose the same as your stream resolution. And now we have the blank canvas where we can add as many things as we want, basically. First thing we're gonna do is gonna go up left here and change the title of the overlay. So this is gonna be our game slash desktop overlay. So let's say it's gonna be screen overlay, just a basic simple overlay. And the first thing we have to do is of course add a widget. So this brings up the menu here and you can see we have alerts. We're gonna talk about alerts in a future video, but for this video we just want to add an overlay design. So we're gonna have to go to static slash custom and add an image. So this little box here is basically our image. We can set a new image here. And I have all these designs here already, but for you, you just have to click upload and get your design from your PC. If you don't have an overlay design yet, then just go and make one. It's not really that difficult. But if you have absolutely no idea how to do any of this, then just hire someone or ask a friend to do it for you. So the first thing I'm gonna add to my overlay is a webcam frame. I actually use an animated one, but for this video, I'm gonna choose an image. Just upload this here and make sure this is selected and submit it. And there you go, you have your webcam frame, which you can place literally wherever you want. You can resize it in many ways. For now, let's place it right here to the right side of the screen. The next thing we can add to our overlay is a goal of some sorts. If you're starting out, I imagine the best goal for you would be a follower goal. So we're gonna add a follower goal right now. And for this, let's click the plus icon down here, go to labels, followers, goals, and add a follower goal. So this brings up the bar here, and you can customize it pretty much in any way you want, starting from the colors, and you can even set it to a simple minimalistic design as well. So let's say you're starting out with zero followers and you want to reach your goal of 100 followers. If you already have gained some followers, as you can see I have, if you go up here to session data and then go down to goals, you can reset or start a new goal progress. So if I type 0 in the follower goal progress and save it, then now it's gonna go down to 0 and I start from 0 again. So one idea this can be used for is if you wanna grow by 100 followers every month. So let's make it look like this as well, followers this month. We can even see the percentage of completion. This is all personal preference here, but I like to use it in a condensed design. It looks a little bit cleaner like this. And of course you can change the colors to whatever you want. And also what's really cool is you can use custom fonts if you want. And again, you can resize it. You can change the font size of the text as well. But for now, I'm gonna drag this out of the way and let's place it down here. I'm gonna make it smaller. And there you go. Let's click save. And now we have our webcam frame and we have a follower goal. Obviously you can add another goal if you want. You can add the subscriber goal, you can add bits goal, tips goal. And another thing, of course, if somebody follows our stream, then we want to thank them and we want to make them noticed on our stream. So we're gonna add a latest follower text as well. And obviously just place it wherever you want. It makes sense to bring it closer to your webcam frame so people can see it more often. And again, you can customize it however you want. I'm just gonna leave it right here, just like this. Again, just to remind you that this is a basic tutorial. I'm not gonna go in depth on everything you can do here. If you want me to do an in-depth tutorial about any of this, then just leave a comment down below. And also that's a good time to remind you to subscribe as well. And even like this video if you like it so far. And yeah, let's move on. I also want to add a chat overlay because then people who, for example, watch my streams in full screen don't have to worry about missing the chat. So for this, we're gonna go to the plus sign again, go to stream tools and add your stream's chat. That's how easy it is really. And as you can see, there's also a lot of customization. Currently the chat is on a dark background, which I feel can obscure some views on the stream. So I wanna make it transparent. And for this I go to custom and here you can set the background color. And all you have to do here is if you have this bar here, it's probably set up here. Just bring it down here to the end and click select and then your chat is transparent. Now click save again and there we go. We now have completed our basic set of an overlay and already our stream is looking a little bit more professional. The last thing we need to do is actually bring this overlay into OBS Studio so we can actually show it on stream. For this, just go find this chain here, copy overlay URL, copy it, and in OBS Studio, just choose your scene. Add a new browser source. I'm gonna rename it to screen overlay. Click OK. Paste the link over here. Also important thing, we have to change the resolution here. So we went by 1600 by 900. So let's type that in and press OK. And now as you can see, we're literally done with it. It's easy as that. We can test if our chat works by typing something into our stream chat. Okay, the text color needs to be adjusted a little bit, but it basically works. That's the idea. So just play around with these things here. Obviously you can add a lot more overlays to different scenes you have, like be right back screen, separate desktop and gaming screen. You can also add a just chatting screen, which I use a lot in my streams whenever I just want to chat with my viewers. I hope by showing you these basics, you got a pretty good overview of what you can do in OBS Studio and Streamelements. And obviously what you need to do right now is to just go in Streamelements and just play around with the overlays. See what you like, see what you don't like, and make it your own. Make sure your stream overlay suits your brand and your style. In the next video, we're gonna add a bunch of alerts to our stream, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss it. Leave a like for this video as well, so more people who need help setting up their stream can find this video. That is it for today. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. GG.